Hi, everyone. Today is my second session about IDS Next and AI. In this session, I'm going to talk about the possibilities of IDS Next, the cameras, and also our complete solution. But first, let me give you a short refresher of the last session. The most important thing with setting up an AI-based project is to find the right task. Here you can see three example tasks that are suitable with deep learning. First is classification. With classification, you can create easy solutions like good or bad decisions or absence-presence decisions. The second one is object detection. With object detection, you can, for example, count objects in an image, you can locate them, find the position, or you can do an assembly control, for example. And the third one is segmentation. This is mainly used for surface analysis. And the training of those three tasks is called supervised learning. Supervised learning means that you need to annotate each image prior to the training. And for example, with the classification, you need to annotate good images and bad images. There's one fourth task. This is the anomaly detection. Recognizes differences between the trained images. And this is why we call the training unsupervised learning, which means we only need to train good sample images, and it then automatically can say that something is different in the image or that something is bad. And now I will show you two sample use cases that we already can solve with IDS Next. First one is classification. In this case, we have fixed multiple RIs, and we can analyze the growth or inspect the growth status of cress in this case. We can differentiate if it's sowed or already sprouting. And the second one is object detection. In this case, we can find litter in soil. So some of you might know already this stairway from my last presentation. And I want to go a little bit more in detail in this one. Especially the AI knowledge is one of the main reasons why companies don't want to use or engage with AI, because they're missing knowledge already. 56% of the companies say that they are missing the expertise, and that's the reason why they don't want to use AI. The next higher step is the programming skills and also the programming time that is needed. So 70% of the companies say that they don't have time to code training with a new framework that they don't know. And the third step why companies don't want to engage with deep learning is that they don't have enough money for buying a training server, for example. 38% of the companies say that they are missing money. So now we go more to the persons that use AI, and that are the users on the lower end and the developers in the middle of the stairway. The users are usually non-specialists for image processing. They usually operate machines or are domain experts when they control or check the quality in their productions. And the developers are usually skilled developers with programming knowledge and deep learning knowledge, and they have a different level of of knowledge in the stairway. And for both of those people, we do have a solution. Let's go on with the user solution. So here you can see the stairway, which is quite high, and especially for the user that is on the lowest end of the stairway, it can be a major effort to go on with all the steps. And this is the reason why we wanted to make it more easy. With IDS Next Ocean, we flattened this stairway. And yeah, it's flattened to a really low level to make it as easy as possible. Well, now I will talk a little bit more in detail about what IDS Next Ocean is. To do this, we will follow the whole process that usually goes with AI projects. First, you need to collect data. After that, you will need to label images, and then to train it to get a neural network. And after the training, you need to deploy it. And for collecting data, we have the IDS Next cockpit. It's a host software that helps you to collect image data and already label the data during the acquisition. The next two steps, labeling and training, can be solved with IDS Next Lighthouse. This is our cloud-based training software where you can upload those collected images, label them, and then you can train easily without coding a neural network. And for deployment, we have our IDS Next cameras, where you can upload the trained neural networks and then run the inference on the camera. But this is not all. We already have lots of turnkey vision apps where the users can use directly different tasks. For example, we have the object detection and classification, but we also have a person detector where you can detect a person, but also you can pixelize persons and many more. And all of this is called IDS Next Ocean. We also call it the solution to grab, label, train, and run artificial intelligence. So now we will start with the developers. For developers, we have a different approach because they want to engage more with the topic, want to find the best possible solution for their application. And that's why we flattened the curve, or we flattened the stairway at a little bit higher point, so that the experts that do already have AI knowledge and programming skills can develop their own algorithms, their own neural networks, and then we give them some tools to also deploy it on the camera. And here you can see the tools. First thing is the Vision App Creator. With the Vision App Creator, we have an IDE, a development environment with the IDS Next toolchain, where developers can create their own vision apps that can be deployed on the camera. This can also be contain classic rule-based image processing algorithms based on, for example, OpenCV or C++. But the developers can also use the CNN accelerator on the camera and use their own CNNs inside those vision apps. This is pretty cool. But for customers that don't want to create vision apps by themselves, but want to use their own neural networks, we have IDS Next Ferry. And here, the developers can create their own neural networks, for example, with TensorFlow or Keras, and then they can convert those those neural networks and can upload them on the camera. Some of our customers already created their own vision apps. Let's have a look what is possible with the IDS Next Vision App Creator and IDS Next Ferry. Okay, so now we had those two solutions. The one thing is the whole ready-to-use turnkey solution, IDS Next Ocean, and the other one is the solution for experts with our development tools. Here you can see IDS Next Ocean and also our expert tools. And those whole system is part of our IDS Next platform. I think this is a really great solution, and to make it much more easy for you to start with, we created our IDS Next Design In Kit, which contains all the necessary products. So if we look inside, you have the camera, a tripod plate, you also have a license for IDS Next Lighthouse, and the cables and a lens. So all the things you need to start right now with creating your first AI project. So now we are going to do a short summary. With IDS Next, we have a solution for non-AI specialists, which makes it really easy to use deep learning in your own production. We also do have a solution for developers that have specific problems and want to dive deeper into the topic. It's really easy to use, and it's perfect to start with small projects and to move fast, to gain quick results and roll it out into your whole production. So that was all from my side for today's session, and thank you for being here today.